and welcome to my shop logo follow-up video. I want to start off by saying thank you. I had very, very positive responses on the logo. People seem to really like it. Let's go ahead and talk about a few of the comments and questions that I got. Ron Martina asked about the blade I was using as well as the speed of my saw. I used an Olson 620 2/0 crown tooth blade, and because I was cutting eighth inch material, it wasn't hard on the blade at all. One blade did the entire project. And in regard to speed of the saw, I had to kind of guesstimate on that. As you can see, the dial on my saw goes from 1 to 8. I have it set right about at 5. I went online and found out that the lowest strokes per minute the saw can run is about 400. The highest is about 1750. So I subtracted 400 from 1750. Then I divided that by 8, the total number of settings, and multiplied the answer by 5, and I came out with just shy of about 850 strokes per minute. Al over at OldMan719 asked about my ruler that I was using. And this is a Inkara Rules 12-inch precision T-rule. It measures down to a 64th of an inch. You can take a 5mm lead pin and place it in any one of these holes, lay it against your wood, and make a perfect score mark right down the wood. I originally purchased this from Woodcraft, probably 10 to 12 years ago for $39.99, and I bought it because at the time I was doing quite a bit of chip carving, and this was perfect for laying out my blanks for that. Brian Benz asked me how I went about designing my logo, and I cannot take all the credit for that. My sister absolutely loves to use Photoshop and loves to just design. She's incredibly good at it. And I called her and said, hey, you know, I have my YouTube channel, RJBWoodTurner, and I'd like to come up with an idea for a logo. And I kind of told her a few things. I'd like to have, you know, my RJBWoodTurner in it and make it wood grain or whatever. And she put together about 10 to 12 logos and sent them to me. And I picked out a couple I really liked. And at the time, I posted some of them out on my Facebook page and got some input from some of the folks out there. And I picked the pieces that I liked from 2 or 3 of them and combined them and asked her to take another shot at it. And she came back with my current logo. And I have to tell you, I was extremely happy with it. I absolutely love what she did. And for my sister Cheryl, I need to say thank you. I definitely appreciate all the hard work you put into that. Wood by Wright asked me where I plan to hang the logo. Now let me show you what my plan is. Please excuse the disaster that is my shop bench. I have not cleaned my shop since the last project. I haven't been in the shop for a few days, so I haven't had an opportunity, but I plan to do future filming for shop updates in front of this bench. And one of the things I want to do is up here on the wall, when I built the house, I had them incorporate an outlet and a cable jack. So I plan to mount a 32-inch TV on this wall, and I'll be able to hook HDMI from my laptop into it so that I can watch YouTube videos, etc. I'm waiting to hang everything, and you can see several items. I've got a couple of things back on the wall there that I want to hang, but I'm waiting to hang everything on this wall until I get the TV, because I don't want to put something up and then have to move it. I want to get the TV up, and then I'll build everything around it. Mark Christopher made the comment that he and I use the same 2x4 method for holding up the scroll saw. Let me show you what he meant by that. When you're using a scroll saw, many times you'll be cutting out the inside of a piece of wood. And what you need to do is raise this armature up out of the way so that you can thread this very thin blade through the hole that you've made in your wood. But as soon as you let go of the armature, it comes back down. So what we like to do is we just take a block of wood. It can be a piece of 2x4, just a chunk of anything. Raise the armature up, stick it right under there. It holds it up so that you can work with the blade, get your piece of wood threaded. When you're done, you just slide it out of the way, lower the armature, and you're ready to tighten the blade down, and you're back cutting. That's all of the questions and comments that I got this week. I don't have a lot to report because my son played Chip the Teacup in Beauty and the Beast, and this past weekend, I went to 4 performances from Friday to Sunday, and this coming weekend, I've got a performance on Saturday and Sunday that I'm going to. So I have not worked in the shop since my last update video. The hot project I'm working on is my Dust Deputy dust collector. Now I want to let you guys know, I haven't even put it together yet and I've already upgraded. I was able to get my hands on roughly about a 30-gallon, it's a heavy cardboard a container with a metal lid. I think that's going to be perfect because it versus the 5-gallon bucket, I'm not going to have to empty it as often. I'm really excited about that. I should get my hands on that tomorrow. And when I do, I'll go ahead and everything's ready to go. I just have to put it together. And that's probably going to be my video this week. I apologize for not having more for you, but you know, I am a family man first and a woodworker second. So we're gonna have some good time at the play this weekend. I want to thank you for joining me for this shop update. I want you to know that you are always welcome in my shop. Come back and see me again real soon. Have a great evening, everybody.